Hello, we're down in 6 Acre Meadow with Elliot Newton, Biodiversity Officer at Kingston Council. And we're down here to have a chat about balsam bashing. So what we want to do today is basically find out what is balsam, why do we bash it, and why should we bash it, and how should we bash it. Over to you, Elliot.
Thanks, Simeon. Yes, so hello everyone. So this is Himalayan balsam, and it's what we call an invasive species. And just to give you a bit of background of Himalayan balsam before I say why we need to do it or how to do it, is like, what is it? So this is a species that unsurprisingly originates from sort of the Himalayan regions, and it is brought over in sort of by the Victorians, because it's got a beautiful flower when it goes to flower. And when they brought it over, it absolutely thrives in our environment. So this plant, it's still very early days at the moment, so they're not as big as they will grow. They can grow quite easily, a lot taller than I can. And each plant can produce over 800 seeds, so it can absolutely spread. And when it goes to seed, they have these seed pods. And if you touch it, they have this mechanism called balacory, which means they explode and spread these seeds out. And it really makes them be able to overtake the sort of various flora that's around. So it overdominates, outcompetes all the sort of other wildflowers that should be here. And another issue with Himalayan balsam is pollination. So obviously they produce these flowers, and things like pollinators, like bees for example, will come and pollinate them, which is what you'd expect. But when a bee visits this Himalayan balsam, it will only ever go back to Himalayan balsam. So that means all the other plants that we want to get pollinated and have that diversity of flora to improve biodiversity and the taxonomic diversity and for invertebrates and all sorts of species, by having that out-competitive mechanism that these guys have, because they're fast growing, they're seed dispersal like I've already talked about, and also their ability to sort of reduce pollination of other plants, it's so important that we try and get it out to try and make our area better for biodiversity more generally. So what do we need to do? So the very good thing about Himalayan balsam pulling, it is incredibly satisfying to do, especially when they get a little bit bigger. But you can see here, this is firstly it's probably best to show what they look like. So they are they've got these sort of purple sort of strands to them, as you can see, so rather sort of large leaves, a very sort of the stem is very it's got quite a lot of water content to it, so it's quite a flexible stem. You can hear it crunch, it's got a real crunching sound to it because it's absolutely lots of water in there. And the root ball has this purple sort of coloring to it too. But a really good way, if you're a bit confused about if it's Himalayan balsam or not, is giving it a pull. So Himalayan balsam, as you can see here, as it's absolutely everywhere around me, it comes out really easily. If you're yanking it and pulling it and it's not coming out, that means it's not balsam. But this, because it comes out nice and easily, is balsam. So once you've got it in the hand, it's very important to try and stop it from reproducing. You give it a crack and a twist, and then you can just pile it up, and then that will mean that it's no longer a viable plant, and therefore it won't be able to reproduce. But we need to do it lots and lots, because you can see it's absolutely everywhere. So the more, if we've got everybody out here across the whole hogs mill, that's 6 Acre Meadow, all over the place, doing this, crunching it out, pulling it out, that'll be a really fantastic conservation effort to really improve the biodiversity value of the area. So it'd be amazing if you guys could get out here on your daily walks or whenever you're walking around. If you see it, just give it a pull and a crack and a twist, and then pop it on the floor.
And Elliot, should we wear gloves for doing this? What do you recommend?
I always recommend using gloves, not least for, you know, you're going to come into contact with all sorts of things, obviously nettles, which can potentially sting you, and brambles, which can cut you. So obviously by having gloves on, you'll have that more sort of protective layer on your hands, which is obviously very important. And also it will reduce the chance of if you do come into contact with things like dog mess and stuff like that, will give you an extra protective layer. If you are using bare hands like I am, it's very important after you do it that you wash your hands thoroughly. But hopefully we're all doing that anyway at the moment anyway, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem.
That's great. Elliot, thank you so much for coming down and explaining all that. Hopefully people can do it on their daily walks.
Hopefully, yeah. So if everybody did it on their daily walks, our green space would be a much more biodiverse place.
Brilliant. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.